Hi there, Dr. Mungli here. So in this video, I will be explaining you electron transport chain inhibitors and uncouplers mechanism. I will give the examples of electron transport chain inhibitors and examples for uncouplers of electron transport chain and how they work. So if you are watching this video, I recommend you to watch my previous video on mechanism of electron transport chain. The link for that is there in the description below, and also it is appearing in the above right corner right now. Now let me just briefly explain electron transport chain mechanism first, and then I'll take you into inhibitors of electron transport chain. So electron transport chain, as you all know, it has complex 1, 2, 3 and 4 embedded in the inner mitochondrial membrane, and they are going to pump protons from the matrix side of mitochondria into intermembrane space. So this pumping, it will be done by three complexes in electron transport chain, and they are complex 1, complex 3 and complex 4. So during this time, basically what happens, oxidation of NADH into NAD plus occurs, and complex 2 will oxidize FADH2 into FADs. And while these things are oxidized, so the protons are pumped as the electrons are moving from complex 1 to coenzyme Q, and then complex 3 cytochrome C, and complex 4. And in the complex 4, there will be use of oxygen. Oxygen atom is going to combine with protons like 2 hydrogen to make water molecule. Okay, so as the protons build up here, so it is going to create a proton motive force here. So as the proton motive force is built up, and the protons, they will pass through this ATP synthase through F0 subunit and fall into the matrix of mitochondria. So in F1 subunit of ATP synthase, ADP will be phosphorylated with PI, inorganic phosphate, to make ATP. So ADP combining with PI to make ATP. So you are generating ATP here. So oxidation is going on here, pumping the protons, and these protons, they will come back into the matrix through ATP synthase, and you are phosphorylating ADP with PI to make ATP. So the phosphorylation process, it is coupled with oxidation, and that is why we refer electron transport chain as oxidative phosphorylation. This is also called as respiratory chain because you are utilizing oxygen in the fourth complex of electron transport chain. So this is what is explained in chemiosmotic theory to explain how ATPs are synthesized in the mitochondria by oxidizing NADH and FADH2. All this I have explained in detail in my video, which the link for that is there in the description below. Now let me take you into inhibitors and uncouplers of electron transport chain. So let's take inhibitor of complex 1. So the complex 1 inhibitor, so we have rotenone is a complex 1 inhibitor, piericidin is a complex 1 inhibitor, amobarbital is a complex 1 inhibitor. What they do? They bind to the complex 1 and inhibit transfer of electrons from complex 1 to coenzyme Q, and then all the way up to oxygen. So by doing so, what happens? So you are basically, the oxidation of NADH plus H plus is decreased. That means there will be more NADH and less NAD plus. If you take the ratio of NADH over NAD, it will be more than 1 because you are not oxidizing NADH. When you are not oxidizing NADH, so you are not transferring electrons here. That means protons are not pumped from the matrix side into the intermembrane space. So that means you are not creating proton motive force. And the proton motive force is not created, that means ATP synthase is not getting sufficient protons to flow through, and that will decrease the phosphorylation process here. That means ATP synthesis will decrease. So inhibitor of electron transport chain will decrease ATP synthesis, and also because electron transport chain is decreased here, that means oxygen consumption will also decrease. So decrease in oxygen consumption, decrease in ATP synthesis, and increase in NADH over NAD ratio is another characteristic feature of complex 1 inhibitor. Example is rotenone, amobarbital, piericidin A. complex 2 inhibitor, we have thionyl trifluoroacetic acid and carboxin, which will bind with complex 2 and decrease ATP synthesis. Now, complex 3 inhibitor, we have antimycin A. This antimycin A, by binding to complex 3, it means it is not going to allow proton coming from NADH oxidation and FADH oxidation into complex 3. So, it means overall electron transport chain, it will decrease. So, as the electron transport chain decreases, consumption of oxygen decreases, so decreased oxygen consumption, proton flow from matrix into the intermembrane space decreases, that means flow of proton through ATP synthase decreases, that means ATP synthesis will decrease. So, complex 3 blocking will decrease ATP synthesis, decrease oxygen consumption, and will increase NADH over NAD ratio and FADH2 over FAD ratio, because they are not used, they are not oxidized. Now, complex 4 inhibitors. Complex 4 inhibitors, we have cyanide, we have carbon monoxide, and we have sodium azide. So, cyanide, some of the sources of cyanide for us is like burning polyurethane, that is the foam present in the mattresses or furniture. If you burn it, it can, one of the byproduct of that burning is cyanide, so it can lead to toxicity. Or acetonitrile. Acetonitrile is present in solvents. So, if there is exposure to this acetonitrile, in one of the metabolic product of acetonitrile is cyanide. And also sodium nitroprusside. This sodium nitroprusside, we use it in enzyme and all that as a vasodilator, because it releases nitric oxide. So, one of the byproduct of sodium nitroprusside is cyanide, and this cyanide can go and bind to complex 4. And the antidote for cyanide is amyl nitrite. This amyl nitrate, the mechanism of amyl nitrite is, amyl nitrate, it is acting as an oxidant on hemoglobin. It is going to convert ferrous iron in the hemoglobin, heme of hemoglobin, into ferric iron. That means you are converting hemoglobin into methemoglobin. And this methemoglobin, it has got a higher affinity for cyanide. So, it is going to bind with the cyanide and become cyanmethemoglobin, and this will be excreted. This is how you can neutralize cyanide, or you can take or decrease the concentration of cyanide in the blood. That is acting as an antidote. Now, the carbon monoxide, which is another thing which will interact, which will bind with the complex 4 of electron transport chain. So, how do you get carbon monoxide? You get it from vehicle exhaust, or like propane heaters, or the gas grills. So, these are some of the sources of our house fires. Some of the sources of carbon monoxide, which can affect complex 4 in electron transport chain. There are some inhibitors which will go and block this F0 subunit of electron ATP synthase, and that is oligomycin, a chemical called oligomycin. It will go and bind to the F0 subunit of ATP synthase, and thereby it block that proton flow, and that means ATP synthesis decreases. As the ATP synthesis decreases, it because flow of proton is not going on here, that means there will be a lot of protons built up in the intermembrane space, that will ultimately affect flow of protons from the matrix into the intermembrane space. So, the complex 1, 3 and 4, they simply fail, giving rise to decreased electron transport chain and decreased ATP synthesis and decreased oxygen consumption. Now, coming to the uncouplers, what uncouplers does? Uncoupler, as the name says, it is going to uncouple oxidation from phosphorylation. I already told you, electron transport chain is called as oxidative phosphorylation because both the processes are coupled here. Oxidation is coupled with phosphorylation process. So, in uncoupling mechanism, what happens? So, uncouplers, basically these are the, we have chemical uncouplers and physiological uncouplers. So, the chemical uncouplers or physiological uncouplers, so what they do is, they basically insert a pore in the electron, in the inner mitochondrial membrane. Say, I'm drawing here something. So, it can be a chemical uncoupler or physiological uncoupler. So, it is acting as a pore in the inner mitochondrial membrane, and what this pore does is, it is going to allow free flow of protons through this pore into the matrix of mitochondria. Now, your protons are moving through this alternate channel, less protons are moving through this. ADP is not phosphorylated with PI to make ATP. That means ATP levels will be less, ADP levels will be more. So, what happens? So, these ADPs, what they would do when they are at high levels, they are going to go to the TCA cycle and keep isocitrate dehydrogenase enzyme active. And this isocitrate dehydrogenase, it will increase the TCA cycle, rate of TCA cycle. More and more NADH and FADH2 are produced, and those NADH and FADH, they get into complex 1 and complex 2 respectively and be oxidized. So your electron transport chain is pumping protons from the matrix into the intermembrane space. But what happens, these protons, they will come back to the matrix through this alternate channel releasing heat. So that means you are not making sufficient ATP. So same thing continues, ATP increased, isocitrate dehydrogenase activated, and TCA cycle running faster, making NADH, FADH, electron transport chain is running faster now, but not really creating ATP. So because of this, electron transport chain works over time much faster. That means oxygen consumption here will increase because overall rate of electron transport chain increased. So the oxygen consumption increased, that means the respiratory rate will also increase. So there will be increase in respiratory rate. So this is what your uncoupler will do to electron transport chain. That means it is going to increase the electron transport chain, and thereby it is going to increase oxygen consumption by increasing respiratory rate. And there is the increase in the body temperature, heat is generated. So, but overall there will be decrease in ATP synthesis. So this is what and if you look at the ratio of NADH over NAD and FADH to over FAD, so the ratio, it will decrease because there will be consumption of more NADH and more FADH2. What are the examples for uncouplers? So we have chemical uncouplers like 2,4-dinitrophenol, 2,4-dinitrophenol, pentachlorophenol, nitrochrysal, and aspirin. Aspirin at high doses, and also salicylate group of drugs like at high doses like Tylenol, which is acetaminophen. So at high doses, they also have uncoupling mechanism. Now then we have physiological uncoupler. So the physiological uncoupler is thermogenin. Thermogenin is uncoupling protein 1. It is present in brown adipose tissue. I have a video on brown adipose tissue. Link for that is appearing in the description below. And also it is there, it is appearing right now on the upper right corner. You can watch that video to understand what exactly is thermogenin and how it functions. So this is all about uncouplers and inhibitors of electron transport chain. So I hope this video has helped you in understanding some of the this particular concept. Thanks for watching, and see you in my next video.